Hello, my name is etneveL and this is Secret Neighbor. This game made from Hello Neighbor, which is also a really good game too. However, you were only able to play it in single player, but now, in Secret Neighbor, you can explore the neighbor's house up to 6 players as kids. But be very careful, one of these kids is the neighbor in disguise. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to play the game, what options we have to help our fellow teammates or code them as a neighbor, plus, I'm going to give you some advice to be better in the game. In the menu, you have to choose if you want to play quick game or custom game. In quick game, you are going to get in a lobby and you can start playing right away. However, in custom lobby, there are a lot of player-made rooms, and this is the best place to play with your friends. In these rooms, you can set your own rules. You can set the name, the password, you can set the time on each game, and you are able to choose how many lock need the kids to open it to go down to basement. Plus, you can even choose to show the player names in game or not. At the bottom left corner, you can choose your characters. You have to choose one kid and one neighbor. There are 6 different types of kids, and you can choose different outfits for them. Currently, there is 2 different types of neighbor. Later on the video, I will tell more about these classes. Let's jump into a match and let's see how to play the game. At the beginning of the game, you will find out are you a child or the neighbor. As the child, your main objective is to open the basement door, which is locked with different locks, so you have to find different keys for that. There are 3 types of different locks, which based on colors. The child wins if they open the door and one of the child enter the basement. As the neighbor, your main objective is to stop the child's opening the door. You can do that by grabbing them and hold them for 10 seconds at least. The neighbor wins if all the children are got caught or the time is up. Every time you play, the houses change, so you can do the same tactic over and over again and go to the same room. In the house there are different drops too, different items. There are some basic ones like boxes, chairs. With those you can block doors, but there are some really interesting ones like the flashlight, which gives you light of course. There is the glue, which can slow the players. There is the saucepan, and you can use that as a helmet, which is an armor. But the best item in the game is the toy gun, which is a one-shot, one-kill weapon, but you have only one shot. The items in this game are really important, because that's the basic way to damage the neighbor. Most important thing is, if the neighbor is got your teammate, you can help him or her by throwing the neighbor with one of your items. If you throw him, he got stunned and he will immediately drop the kid. I don't want to spoil every item, so you have to try it out. That's the basics of the game, so let's talk about the classes. As I said, there is 6 type of childrens and there is 2 types of neighbor. Most of the classes has passive abilities and quest abilities too. The first big boy is the beggar. The beggar has a backpack which is let him to have 3 items at the same time. Every character has only 2 items. The beggar quest is, if he has 3 items for 2 minutes, he will get an additional slot. The beggar is also get less fall damage by 20%, and if the neighbor is get him, the neighbor is going to move slow while he is holding him. The next one is the brave. Brave has an only quest ability, which is if she hits the neighbor, she gets his passive ability. If the neighbor is get him, she can stun him and escape from the neighbor. The next one is a smart guy. He is the detective. He got a photo about a key. That ability is really useful if the player is really know the house well. His quest ability is if he get 2 items with his main ability, he get 1 key outlined in the house. The next character is my favorite one and he is also a smart guy. He is the inventor. Inventor ability is he can collect gears. With gears he can craft different items. His quest ability is if he gets 5 gears, he can use the clocks and he can move the cage walls like the neighbors. The next little girl is the leader. The leader's special ability is the inspiration. It has a cooldown Inspiration is a speed up for older children within 10 meter radius. She has also a quest ability too, which is she inspires 25 children, which is dazzling the neighboring 4 meter radius when she uses Inspire. The last children is the Scout. Scout has a slingshot, which is dealing 10 damage per hit. She is using nuts. She can only hold 15 nuts. She has also a quest ability, which is if she hit the neighbor 3 times in a row, she get a permanent 15% movement speed. Okay, let's talk about the neighbors. There are two types of neighbors. There is the classic one and the other is the clown neighbor. The classic neighbor's abilities are the hunting trap. His second ability is disguise. If we use this item, we get the closest kid appearance. The last one is the rage, which is a passive ability. If the neighbor gets hit 5 times in a row, he will become unstoppable for a short amount of time when he is in block stance. You can block with the neighbor with a middle mouse button. The clown neighbor is actually an interesting one. He has a smoke bomb, which has a cooldown, and if kids get into that smoke, they're gonna get the damage. His passive ability is the confusion. If he caught a kid and suddenly that kid escapes, the kid gonna get dazzled and he will move slower. His last item is a camouflage. He can turn a random item in the household. However, you can find out which is the neighbor because that item has a mustache on it. But it's really fun. So we know how to connect the game, how the game works, and we finally know about the classes. So let's talk about the superb advices I have for you. First of all, if you are a children, try to stay in group because you don't have much chance against the neighbor when you are alone, plus the neighbor has an easier chance to get you. If you have a teammate next to you, then you can cover each other. No matter which character you play, always use your abilities, because if you don't use it, you're just wasting it. Always listen to conversations. It's really hard to do sometimes, because if you are not close to people, you can't hear them. But if they call out someone, then you have an information who is the neighbor, so you know who you have to look out for. However, you also need to be really careful with disinformation because sometimes people can lie. And lie is a powerful weapon in this game. Also, be committed with others. It's really fun to play when you speak to each other. Try to know the house well, because that depends on your life. If you don't know it really well, you're probably gonna get caught and you're gonna lose your game. Manage your inventory well, because you only have 2 slots. Even with beggar, 3 slots is not enough for everything. Okay, that's all about children's. Okay, let's talk about neighbor. First of all, try to isolate the children. It's not an easy thing to do, because that's your only chance to code them. Always use your safe room. It's located in the heart of the house and you can go into it with your bookshelf. In that safe room, you are able to see where the children are for a limited time, plus you can see your doors. Try to use your cage doors smartly, because if you trap a kid and you cut his way out, you have a better chance to coat him. Don't try to be too aggressive with the kids. If you try to coat someone at the beginning and you miss him, you're probably gonna get called out and all the kids will know you are the neighbor and you have zero chance to win the game because they're gonna stay in group. Try to use your abilities smartly. If you play classic neighbor, I usually do use disguise a lot of times and they don't know my real identity is and they're gonna suspect a completely different kid. This is all my advices. I really like Secret Neighbor. This is a really good game to play with friends or with strangers. I always have a good time to play it. I really hope I helped you with this guide video. And now you should probably play Secret Neighbor and code some kids. Or code the neighbor. That's all from me. Thanks for watching and have a good time. Goodbye.